Swahili relative of time, po. Hello dears, welcome again to another session of Swahili language. We are going to learn about relative of time with the infix po. Karibuni sana. The English word when can be translated into Swahili in two different ways depending on the sentence. In a question, it is always translated as lini, as we have learned in our previous lessons. Examples: ulikuja lini Africa? When did you come to Africa? So here you can see lini is translated as when in English. Utakwenda lini Ujerumani? When are you going to Germany? So, we also see here how lini has been used in this sentence as when. Whenever the English word when is not used as a question word, but rather as a conjunction introducing a subordinate clause, it needs to be translated with the Swahili relative of time po. It is used to refer to a certain point of time when something happened, and never as a question word. Examples: nilipofika Tanzania, nilianza kujifunza Kiswahili. Nilipofika Tanzania, nilianza kujifunza Kiswahili. The meaning in English is, when I arrived in Tanzania, I started to learn Swahili. When I arrived in Tanzania, I started to learn Swahili. Alipoishi Ufaransa, aliweza kuongea Kifaransa. Alipoishi Ufaransa, aliweza kuongea Kifaransa means when he or she lived in France, she could speak French. Walipokwenda Kenya, waliona wanyama wengi. When they went to Kenya, they saw a lot of animals. So here in all these three examples of sentences, we are seeing the relative of time po in each sentence. Number one, nilipofika. Number two, alipoishi. And number three, walipokwenda. And the English translation is when I arrived, when she or he lived, or when they went to Kenya. The relative of time po is inserted between the tense marker and the verb stem. It can be used with the past, present, and future tense. The syllable ka is inserted between the tense marker ta and the relative of time po. Here we can see 10 examples in order to learn how all this works. Example number one. Nilipojifunza, when I learned. Ulipokula, when you eat. Alipokunywa, when she drank. Tunapokwenda, when we go. Mnapopika, when you cook. Wanapofagia, when they sweep. Nitakapokwenda, when I go, or when I will go. Utakapokuja, when you come. Watakapofika, when they arrive. Watakapolipa, when they pay. So here we see the pronouns, the verb stem, and how the relative of time po is used or translated as when. So in each line here, you can see the relative of time, and it is translated by the first word when in English from all the 10 examples that we have here. Now we have an exercise. Number one, use the relative of time po and your own ideas to construct the first halves of the following sentences. Sentence number one. Dash dash dash, nilinunua mchele. Nilinunua mchele means I bought rice. Number two, niliona kangaroo wengi. Niliona kangaroo wengi in English is I saw a lot of kangaroo. Now we are going to the exercise number two, which says use your own words to complete the following. Use your own words to complete the following. Number one, alipokwenda Ngorongoro, dash, 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 dash. When he or she went to Ngorongoro, dash, dash, dash. Number two, mtakapokuja kunitembelea, then you fill the blank. Mtakapokuja kunitembelea means when you come to visit me. And that is the end for today. Tomorrow we'll be having a session about Swahili verbs of Arabic origin and those of Bantu origin. Now we are moving to the verbs, and if you remember well, in the previous lessons we were learning about adverbs of Arabic origin. Now we are coming to verbs of Arabic origin as well as those of Bantu origin. Please don't miss this session. Thank you.